Hi, you're watching Nord Tuning. On this episode, we're gonna weigh the pistons and the rods. But first, we're gonna look at the tools we have to use. This is the setup I use. I have tried this in the past, but the scale I had then wasn't accurate enough. When I removed some material from the rod and weighed it again, it got a gram heavier, so that didn't work. The right scale I got from Amazon, it weighs up to 5 kilograms and the accuracy is to 1/100th of a gram. The left scale is an old scale I have, it weighs up to 300 gram and the accuracy is 1/1000th of a gram. And we have to be within a gram, so they're fine. The rear support works fine. I added some extra weight to make it nice and stable on the scale. The support alone weighs 2 kilograms, so it's a benefit to have a heavy duty scale. A setup like this on the small end doesn't work. The variation is too big. I can demonstrate this. Now you can see the small end has become 5 grams lighter than before, so this isn't good. In the video I use a different setup, and if I will do this again, I will make a setup with a bearing inside the small end. These are the pistons I'm gonna use. They are Motronic pistons. They have a compression ratio from 10.2 to 1. They are slightly heavier than the stock piston. I can show you. This piston weighs in about 496 grams. So now for the stock piston. It is 20 grams lighter than my new pistons. And now for the old Motronic piston, it's 5 grams heavier than my new pistons, so that's good. And now for the piston pins, these are the new ones. As you can see, the inside diameter of the new ones is smaller, it's about 13 millimeters, and the old ones have an inside diameter of 14 millimeters. That means the new ones are heavier. I can show you on a scale. 140 grams. And now for an old one. It's 12 grams lighter, almost 13 grams lighter than the new ones. So I measured the old ones, and they fit very well in the new pistons, so I'm gonna use the old piston pins. So now I weighed the pistons, piston 1 being the lightest piston and piston 4 being the heaviest piston. I also weighed the piston pins, piston pin 1 being the lightest piston and piston pin 4 being the heaviest. Piston pin 1 is combined with piston 4 and piston pin 4 is combined with piston 1. Well, now we can see what a difference between the sets is and we can weigh them. Assuming that piston 1 is still the lightest, see what it weighs. Put it at 0 and see what piston 2 weighs. 1.4 grams heavier. Piston 3, 1.5 grams heavier. And piston 4, 2 grams heavier. So that's good, but we still gonna try to make them equal. Okay, now we have to make the sets equal in weight. I will do this by removing some metal from the inner side of the piston pin. For set number 4, I have to remove 1 gram on this side and 1 gram on that side. I will do this by the first layer, hardened layer of steel, I will cut with a stone. And when I'm through the hardened layer, I will take a carbide cutter. Almost there. So results. This was the heaviest set. This is the worked piston pin. I've used a normal drill like this, put a rubber hose on it and put a piston pin in it. Then you can grind it down. Now, let's weigh them. Piston 1, 0, 2, 0, piston number 3, 0. And piston number 4, 0. Well, the aim was 1 grams, but this is perfect. Okay, so I did the same trick with the connecting rods. These are the numbers. There is only a difference of 2 grams. I also weighed the bolts. There was only a difference of 0.5 gram, and the nuts, the difference between the nuts was 0.3 grams. So now I'm going to combine the heaviest connecting rod with the lightest parts. So, and now for the final balancing of the connecting rods. This is the setup I use. It was very hard to find a stable setup. The numbers kept on changing until I used this setup, and now it's stable enough to balance the connecting rods. So here are the results. This is connecting rod 1, the total weight, the small end and the big end weight. For connecting rod 2, it's slightly heavier at 1.74, only the big end is much heavier, about 3.15 grams. And we see this problem with all the other connecting rods. So the big end is much too heavy, and the small end of the lightest connecting rod is the heaviest, and about 1 gram heavier than the rest. So to correct this, I removed part of the bolts, the connecting bolts, shorten them. This will lose about 2 grams and add about 1 gram to the small end, because it's behind the pivot point of the big end bearing. So then all the connecting rods were much closer. A connecting rod 2 was within spec, also connecting rod 4. Only for connecting rod 3, there was a bigger difference. This difference is almost 2 grams, and this difference is also almost 2 grams. So the only way to go, because the total weights were almost the same, the only way to go was to make the small end of a connecting rod one lighter. I did this by removing the edge from the small end just by file. Then I could bring up the other connecting rods within the same spec. And here you see the numbers in red. I removed almost 1 gram from the small end. Here also. So there is a less than 1 gram difference. Also for this one. This was also very light, it stayed the same. I removed some more weight of the back of the connecting rod. And then all the numbers were in spec. Where you see the red numbers, they are the last measurements.
So these are the numbers. They will be supplied to the guy who balances our crank. And I will see you on the next video. Bye.